فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The naqil al-ijma, the transmitter of that ijma is Nawawi. In Sharh al-Sahih al-Muslim, he brings, rahimahullah, in Kitab al-Imara, Babu wujub ta'at al-umara, he says, وَأَمَّا الْخُرُوجِ عَلَيْهِمْ, going against the Muslim leader, وَقِتَالُهُمْ, and fighting with the Muslim leader, فَحَرَامٌ, it is haram, بِإِجْمَاعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, by consensus of the Muslims, وَإِنْ كَانُوا فَسَقَةً, even if they are wrongdoers and transgressors, ظَالِمِينَ, even if they are oppressors, وَقَدْ تَظَاهَرَتِ الْأَحَادِيثَ, and the ahadith have become clear in that regard, عَلَى مَا ذَكَرْتُ, that which I have mentioned, وَأَجْمَعَ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ, he brings another consensus again, he says, وَأَجْمَعَ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ, أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ have unanimously agreed upon, أَنَّهُ لَا يَنْعَزِلُ السُّلْطَانُ بِالْفِسْقِ, that a leader who is a fasiq is not taken down. Ahlul Sunnah unanimously agree that a leader who is a transgressor, he is a wrongdoer, he is a criminal, he's not taken from his position. لا ينعزل السلطان بالفسق, he's not taken from his position. This is ijma. Hafiz Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani also transmitted ijma. He said, قال ابن بطال, Ibn Battal is one of the a'imma who done sharh al-Sahih al-Bukhari. He's, Hafiz Hajar says in Fathul Bari, he says, وَفِي الْحَدِيثِ حُجَّةِ عَلَىٰ تَرْكِ الْخُرُوجِ عَلَىٰ السُّلْطَانِ, he said, Ibn Battal said that in this hadith there's an evidence that you have to leave off going against the ruler, وَلَوْ جَارَ, even if he exceeds his limits, he oppresses, he wrongs his people. وَقَدْ أَجْمَعَ الْفُقَاهَا, and the scholars, the fuqaha, the jurists, they unanimously agree upon, عَلَى وُجُوبِ طَاعَةِ السُّلْطَانِ, that you have to obey the leader, الْمُتَغَلِّبِ, the one who lashed, he beat his people, he killed to come to power. You have to obey him. أَجْمَعَ الْفُقَاهَا, the jurists, and the fuqaha, they unanimously agreed, عَلَى وُجُوبِ, that it's obligatory, طَاعَةَ السُّلْطَانِ, the obedience of the leader who's al-mutaghallib, he came by force, he powered everybody, like what happened in Egypt, وَالْجِهَادِ مَعَهُ, and they believe jihad has to be done with him, وَطَاعَتَهُ, and they believe he has to be obeyed, خَيْرٌ, it is better, مِنَ الْخُرُوجِ عَلَيْهِ, to go against him, لِمَا فِي ذَلِكَ. This is all the statement of Ibn Battal, Ibn Hajar is transmitting. لِمَا فِي ذَلِكَ, because in that is what? مِنْ حَقْمِ الدِّمَى, the blood will be saved. The blood will be saved if the people just listen and obey him and they don't go against him. وَتَسْكِينِ الدَّهْمَى, and it is also to protect the dim-witted ones coming out. What does the word دَهْمَى mean? التَّسَوُّق, it means the ignorant ones. دَهَمَجُ الرَّعَى أَتْبَعِ كُلِّ نَاعِقِ, they will come out and they will just kill people, and the rapists will come out, the pedophiles will do what they want, everybody who has their agenda will do what they want. This is what, by listening and obeying him, this is the good that comes about with it. وَحُجَّتُهُمْ هَذَا الْخَبَرُ, and their evidence, Ibn Battal said, is the narration that was just mentioned. وَغَيْرُهُ مِمَّا يُسَاعِدُهُ, and many other narrations that support that. وَلَمْ يَسْتَثْنَوْا, Allahu Akbar, the only exception that they gave in this regard, مِنْ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا إِذَا وَقَعَ مِنَ السُّلْطَانِ الْكُفْرُ الصَّرِيحِ, the only exception that they allowed for the people to go against the leader is if he comes with clear-cut kufr. Intaha kalamu, his statement is finished. I put two scholars who bring ijma, right? I'll make it a third person. Qala al-imam ibn Baz rahimahullah, Ibn Baz, he said in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, he says, وَهَذِهِ الدَّوْلَةِ, Ibn Baz says, this government, Saudi Arabia, بِحَمْدِ, with the praise of Allah, لَمْ يَصْدُرْ مِنْهَا, it has not occurred from her, from it, مَا يُوجِبُ الْخُرُوجَ عَلَيْهَا, anything that necessitates for the people to uprise against this government, it hasn't come from it. وَإِنَّمَا الَّذِي يَسْتَبِيحُ الْخُرُوجِ, and the ones who permit going against this government, عَلَى الدَّوْلَ بِالْمَعَاصِ, the ones who permit going against a government, I mean the government, this government, because of the sins that it's doing, هُمُ الْخَوَارِجِ, is the Khawarij. الَّذِينَ يُكَفِّرُونَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ بِالذُّنُوبِ. Those who are making the Muslims kuffar based on sins. So we have a powerful statement from Ibn Baz. What did he refer to those who go against the leaders as? I'm going to mention 30 scholars who say they're Khawarij. 30 imams from the Salaf. All of it's on the notes for you guys. Anyone who goes against a leader and says we're allowed to go against that leader is a Khawarij. Ibn Baz said it, right? 30 scholars said it. I'm going to go over it fast. You can listen to it on the recording and the notes, inshallah ta'ala. Imran took a picture of my notes, so you can go over it. Whatever you can write, write. What you can't, inshallah ta'ala, after the lecture, I'll allow you to copy it, inshallah ta'ala. The first one is Muhammad ibn Hassan al-Shaybani, al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, al-Imam Ali ibn al-Madini, Hafiz al-Kirmani, Sahr ibn Abdullah al-Tustari, Abu Bakr al-Khalal, al-Imam ibn al-Mundhir, Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari, al-Imam al-Barbahari, al-Imam al-Baghawi, ibn Taymiyyah, ibn Abi al-Izz al-Hanafi, ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, ibn Mulaqin, ibn Jarir al-Tabari, al-Ajurri, ابن بطال المالكي ابن عبد البر المالكي الشهرستاني القرطبي ابن مفلح صديق حسن خان عبد الله ابن عبد اللطيف آل الشيخ عبد الرحمن يحيى المعلمي عبد الرحمن ابن قاسم ابن باز الألباني ابن عثيمين شيخ صالح الفوزان الشيخ عبد المحسن العباد. 30 scholars who said going against the Muslim leader due to sins that he has done, it's a khariji concept. Anyone who wants to leave those 30 a'imah, wallahi, I could have got more if I looked more and researched more. These 30, I have their kalam written. So this is very serious. These people who go against the leaders are what? Khawarij. Even if they protest against the leader. Protest. I'm going to bring inshallah ta'ala when we come regarding the shubuhat. When we come regarding the shubuhat, we will inshallah ta'ala bring the kalam of Ibn Uthaymeen. That going against a leader doesn't mean by sword or weapon only, even if you go against him by statement. Because the first khariji was who? The first khariji was who? The first khariji who came out with the Prophet, he said to the Prophet, اِعْدِلْ فَإِنَّكَ لَمْ تَعْدِلْ. Who was the first khariji? The head of the khariji. Dhu Khwaisira. Dhu Khwaisira did not take a sword. He said to the Prophet, be just. He went against the Prophet by statement. اعدل محمد فإنك لم تعدل. He's the first person who brought the mentality of protesting, uprising against the leader, mentioning your opinion. The first person who said that from this ummah, who the Prophet said, I will kill his lineage. I will kill his lineage is who? It was who? Dhu Khwaisira. This is where it goes back to. Inshallah ta'ala, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen's statement. We'll bring it inshallah ta'ala. Also, Ibn Uthaymeen said something regarding that we can't go against a Muslim leader because he's done a sin. We can't go against him, however big that sin may be, as long as it doesn't reach Kufr Akbar. Kufr, which is clear cut. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen was asked about the Saudi government has made obligatory for people to pay fines. And if the people, when the fine is overdue, the Saudi government, what it does is that it increases the fine. So you give you a period of time. If you don't pay more, they charge you more. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen was asked, is this considered dara'ib? Is it haram? He said, na'am, it is. Kulla shay'in yu'khadu bila haqqin. Anything that's taken unjustly from in al-dara'ib, this is considered from the what? It's considered from the dara'ib, the tax, which is haram. Wa huwa muharramun. Here, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah distinguish two things. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, Imam of this time, Ahlul Sunnah, the leader, if he does something wrong, they criticize the sin. They say that this sin is haram, la yajuzu, and they speak about that. But they don't speak about the leader behind his back. They do not speak about the leader behind his back. They speak about the sin. Ya ikhwa, distinguish the two. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen was asked a question about a matter, and he said it's haram. Then he straight away went back to the leader's issue. He said, وَلَكِنْ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ. But what is upon the Muslims is السَّمْعُ وَالطَّاعَ. They need to listen and they need to obey. وَأَنْ يَسْمَعَ لِوُلَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. They need to listen to the Muslim leader. وَيُطِيعُهُمْ. They need to obey him. وَإِذَا طَلَبُوا مَالًا. If he asks from them wealth. أعطاهم إياه. They give their wealth to him. ولا يجوز. It is not permissible. And to تخذ, that a person takes these kind of examples or these kind of issues, مثل هذه الأمور وسيلة. He takes it as a path and he uses these kind of sins as a way إلى القدح في ولاة الأمور. To what? Slander the Muslim leaders. وسبهم في المجالس. And in private gatherings, you start to what? Or even public gatherings, you what? You insult them. You give them names. وما أشبه ذلك. And anything like that. انتهى كلام. Speech finished. شيخ ابن عثيمين رياض الصالحين شرح في رياض الصالحين. He said مهما فسق ولاة الله. However much the leader is فاسق, he is a wrongdoer. However much he is a criminal, مهما. However much he is a فاسق, ولاة الأمور, the Muslim leader, لا يجوز الخروج عليهم. It is not permissible for you to go against him and uprise against him. لو شرب الخمرة, even if he drinks alcohol. لو زنوا, even if he commits zina, and it's known that he commits zina. لو ظلموا, even if the leader is transgressing and he's wronging his people, he's lashing their backs, he's taking their money unjustly. And that's لا يجوز الخروج عليه. It is not permissible to go against him. Now we ask, are you more fearing of Allah than Ibn Uthaymeen and Ibn Baz and these 30 a'immah? So we really need to question ourselves and not the ulama and the people of knowledge. Al-asl al-thalith. The third asl is ليس كل من وقع في الكفر أصبح كافرا. Not every person who falls into kufr becomes a kafir. Not every person who falls into kufr becomes a kafir. إذ قد يوجد عند الواقع في الكفر ما يمنع من تكفيره. Because it could happen something that's preventing you from becoming a kafir. You've come with a statement or a kufr, a statement which is kufr, or an action which is kufr, but you personally may not become a kafir for it. Are we all together? Very good. Where did you get this few state qa'ida from? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 16th volume, page 434, he said, فَلَيْسَ كُلُّ مُخْطِئِ. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, not every single person who does a mistake becomes a kafir. لا, and he's talking about matters which are kufr. لا سيما في المسائل الدقيقة. Especially when there are matters which are very detailed. التي كثر فيها نزاع الأمة. Where the arguments of the people have become what? Have become very high. The disputes regarding it has become very high. So Ibn Taymiyyah says, not every mistake that occurs from a person, he becomes a kafir because of it. Especially if this matter is a detailed matter where there's a lot of disputes regarding it. He also said another more clear statement. He said, وَلَيْسَ لِأَحَدٍ أَن يُكَفِّرَ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. He said, it is not permissible for anybody to make any Muslim a kafir, وَإِنْ أَخْطَأَ وَغَلَطَ. Even if he does mistake and shortcoming, حَتَّى تُقَامَ عَلَيْهِ الْحُجَّةِ. Until the proof is established on this person. وَتَبِينَ لَهُ الْمَحَجَّةِ. And the matter that's been disputed regarding has been clarified for him. وَمَنْ ثَبَتَ إِسْلَامُهُ بِيَقِينٍ. Anyone whose Islam has been affirmed by certainty. لَمْ يَزُلْ. It is not removed. ذَلِكَ عَنْهُ بِشَكِّ. No one is allowed to remove that with doubt. بَلْ لَا يَزُلْ. Rather, it doesn't even go. إِلَّا بَعْدَ إِقَامَةِ الْحُجَّةِ. Unless the proof is established on him. وَإِزَالَةِ الشُّبْهَةِ. And the doubt is removed. Are we all together? Also, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, وَلَكِنَّ الْمَقْصُودَ هُنَا. Ibn Taymiyyah says in another place, in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 23rd volume, page 348, he says, وَلَكِنَّ الْمَقْصُودَ هُنَا. The intent here is, أَنَّ مَذَاهِبَ الْأَئِمَّةِ. The methodology, the view of the scholars is built upon distinguishing between the dua and the thing that he did. هذا التفصيل بين النوع والعين. The thing he did and the one who did it. You have to distinguish between the two. If we agree, number one, that what he did is kufr, that doesn't mean I've agreed that the man who did it is a kafir. So there's two things that are already needed from you. First of all, let's agree that this thing is kufr. Once we do agree that this thing is kufr, we then now have to move on to saying what? That the kufr falls onto him. And this is the mas'ala that we spoke about, which is mutlaqul kufr and kufr which is mu'ayyan, ta'yinul kufr. Also, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen was asked a question in his liqa'i Bab al-Maftuha, rahimahullah. They asked him about these people who are not judging by the book of Allah, and they're not judging by the sunnah of the Prophet, and they are judging by the French laws and the British laws. They brought it into their countries. Are they kuffar? Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, he said in liqa'i Bab al-Maftuha, the first liqa, the question was question 31. Ibn Uthaymeen, he said, هذا يحتاج إلى النظر. This matter, it requires a look. Ah, Wallahi, look at that. An imam, an alim. He doesn't just say, kufar. Ah, he doesn't say that. He says, هذا يحتاج إلى النظر. This matter requires a look. ما هو السبب الذي حملهم على هذا? What is it that made him do this? Why is he judging by the French law? Why the British law? وهل أحد غرهم ممن يدعي العلم? Did somebody who claimed knowledge deceive him into this? وقال أن هذا لا يخالف الشرع, and said to the leader that this doesn't oppose the Sharia, you can do this. أما ذا, or what's the reason? فالحكم في هذه المسألة, the ruling pertaining to this issue, لا يمكن, it is not possible for me to give, إلا على كل قضية بعينها, unless each issue is revised independently. الله أكبر, انتهى كلامه. الله أكبر. فائدة, benefit. To make takfir on a particular individual after it has been agreed that the action, the thing is kufr, after it's been agreed that this action is kufr and this statement is kufr, once it's been agreed, to then take it and place it on the individual, you would need four conditions to be present and four matters to be absent. The four conditions that you would need for it to be present is, number one, knowledge. That person has to have knowledge of this matter. If he's ignorant, then he's excused. The second one is al-qasd. He has to have intended this action. This leader has to have intended this action, or this individual has to have intended the action. Again, I'm saying he intended the what? The action. I'm not saying he intended the kufr. And that's two different things. For example, if I say, for instance, let's just give the hadith of the man who said, Allah, he said to Allah, Anta abdi, you are my slave, wa ana rabbuka, and I am your Lord. Did he get it wrong? أخطأ من شدة الفرح. When he said that, is that not a statement of kufr? Is it not a statement of kufr? It is a statement of a kufr. But is he a kafir for saying that statement? No, he's not a kafir. Why is he not a kafir? Because he got it wrong. He did not intend that statement. He was very happy. He was overwhelmed. So he did a mistake and he did not intend that statement. Number three is ikhtiyar. He had to have the free will. He had to have will. He had to have the choice to do this. And if he was told to do this under duress, he was subjugated into it. Somebody put him at gunpoint, then of course it is not, whatever statements of kufr he says, he's not going to be held account for it. Number four is in idabu ta'wil sa'ikh. There should not be an acceptable interpretation. If he has an acceptable interpretation, which is acceptable, meaning it's understandable interpretation, then he's what? He's excused. If his interpretation is acceptable, when I say acceptable, it means that it's understandable where he's coming from. Of course, it's not acceptable because you'll be told after that that what you're saying is kufr. Okay, but he won't be made a kafir. Why? Why would he not be made a kafir? Because he's got a ta'wil, which is sa'igh, an interpretation that is understandable. The fourth and final principle that we need to agree upon is al-khuruj ala al-hakim al-kafir, going against a Muslim leader who is kafir. So going against a kafir leader. Going against a kafir leader is not unrestricted. You can't unrestrictedly go against a kafir leader. We already said before, you can go against him, right? But it's not unrestricted. It's restricted with some conditions that have to be met. When those conditions are met, then you are allowed to uprise against him. As for a Muslim leader, under no circumstances are you allowed to go against him. But if he's a kafir, you are allowed to go against him under conditions. What are the conditions? First of all, it has to be wuqu'uhu fil kufri al bawah. He has to have fallen into clear-cut kufr alladhi 'indana min Allah fihi burhan, which we have a clear-cut evidence in this regard. We have a proof amam Allah Ta'ala, the day of judgment, where you can say, oh Allah, he came with a clear-cut kufr. We have to have, the kufr here has to be clear. It can't be a matter where the scholars disputed whether if it's kufr or not. It has to be clear-cut kufr. Number two, iqamatu al-hujjati alayhi. The proof has to be established on the leader. Number three, al-qudrati ala izalatihi. We have the ability to remove him. Allahu Akbar. He's kafir, but we have the ability to remove him. What do we have? We have the ability, he's a kafir. We've now agreed that this man has come with clear-cut kufr. Or even he's coming out and saying, I'm no longer a believer. He's coming out and saying, I'm no longer a believer. What do we say? To remove him requires what? Ability. Okay, we'll go into that one in more details. Four is al-qudratu ala tansibi muslimin makanahu. Fourth one is that we are able to place a Muslim in his place. So if this kafir is taken out and we get rid of him, we put in his place what? A Muslim leader. We don't leave the spot empty. Or we don't bring another kafir who's greater in kufr doesn't come. There has to be a Muslim now. So we have to have somebody ready. But after we take him down, we shouldn't say, okay, who's going to take the place? Because what happens? Everybody thinks he's the right one for it. Fold on corruption happens. We need to have the person we're going to put in place. We've already chosen him. It's already agreed upon. And we're going to put that believer in place. Number five is أَلَّا يَتَرَتَّبَ عَلَى هَذَا الْخُرُوجِ. There should not come out from this uprising against this kafir. It should not come from it. مَفْسَدَةٌ, a harm. عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِينَ, on the believers. أَعْذَمٌ مِنْ مَفْسَدَةِ بَقَائِهِ, greater than the harm of him remaining in the seat. Him remaining in the seat is a harm, no doubt about that. A kafir should not run the affairs of the believers. Allah has not made a kafir a wali over the believers. That is definitely a harm. But trying to remove him and get rid of him should not bring about a greater harm. Let me bring the statement of the ulama regarding this issue. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he said about the kafir leader. Now we're talking about somebody we all agree he's a kafir. Ibn Hafidh ibn Hajar said, فَلَا تَجُوزُ طَاعَتُهُ, it is not permissible to obey him. فِي ذَلِكَ, the kafir leader is not obeyed. بَلْ تَجِبُ, rather what is obligatory is مُجَاهَدَتُ, the Muslims have to fight him. They have to remove him. لِمَنْ قَدَرَ عَلَيْهَا, you underline that. For the one who has the ability to do so. Ability means you are able, you have the strength, you have the power, you have the capability. It's not like you're going to take, you're going to what? You're going to bring out, huh, daggers from your house, little knives, huh? Kitchen knives, and go against him. When he's got what? He's got the babat, he's got aeroplanes. Are we all together? Has to be ability. That's the statement of Hafidh ibn Hajar. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِأَرْضٍ هُوَ فِيهَا مُصْطَبْعَفٍ, any believers who are in a land where they're weak, the believers are weak, أو في وقت, or they are at a time, هو فيها مُصْطَبْعَفٍ, or they are in a time when they are very weak, فَلْيَعْمَلْ بِآيَةِ الصَّبْرِ, the Muslims should come with the verses that speak about patience, والصفح, and forgiveness. And مَنْ يُؤْذِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, for those who are harming Allah and His Messenger, we should just be patient and we should just overlook it. We shouldn't go speak about it. مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ, the disbelievers, Christians or the Jews. وَأَمَّا أَهْلُ الْقُوَّةِ, as for the people who have strength, فَإِنَّمَا يَعْمَلُونَ بِآيَةِ الْقِتَالِ, those ones are going to apply the verses of fighting. Fighting with who? أَئِمَّةَ الْكُفْرِ, the leaders of disbelief. Until his statement finishes, rahimahullah. So we are either ahlu quwwa or we are what? Ahlu da'f. We are either people who have strength or we have people. If we're people who are weak, what do we implement? There's nothing we can do. We take the ayat which say, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ قِيلَ لَهُمْ كُفُّوا أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ. كُفُّوا أَيْدِيَكُمْ, hold your hands back, pray your salah, وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ, give your charity. Those ayat is what we take on board. Are we all together? If we have quwwah and we have strength, وَقَاتِلُوا الْمُشْرِكِينَ كَافَّةً كَمَا يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ كَافَّةً. We use them, we take those verses out and we apply them based on our ability. Ibn Baz says, إِلَّا, he's talking about the ayah of Hadith Ubadah ibn Samit, where the Prophet said, don't go against the leader, إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا كُفْرًا بَوَاحًا عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِيهِ بُرْهَانٍ, until you see clear-cut kufr from him. Ibn Baz is explaining the ayah hadith. He said, إِلَّا إِذَا رَأَوْا الْمُسْلِمُونَ, the Muslims have to see kufran bawahan, clear-cut kufr. Who has to see it? The Muslims. So it's not something a group of people saw. It has to be the Muslims. It has to be that clear. It's out there in the open. Everyone knows it. It's out there in the open. Bawahan, clear-cut kufr. عِدَّهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِي بُرْهَانٍ, and they have the evidence for it Imam Allah Ta'ala in the Day of Judgment. فَلَا بَأْسَ, then Ibn Baz said, it's no problem. After he's come with that clear-cut kufr, there's no harm. أَنْ يَخْرُجُ عَلَى هَذَا السُّلْطَانِ, that they go against that leader. لِإِزَالَتِهِ, to remove him. إِذَا كَانَ عِدَّهُمْ قُدَّرَهُ, but if they have the ability and they have the strength. أَمَّا إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ عِدَّهُمْ قُدْرَهُ, but if they don't have the ability and they don't have the strength, فَلَا يَخْرُجُوا, don't go out. أَوْ كَانَ الْخُرُوجُ يُسَبِّبُ شَرًّا أَكْثَرَ, or you going against him will bring out and it will produce a greater evil. فَلَيْسَ لَهُمُ الْخُرُوجُ, it is not permissible for them to go against him. رعاية للمصالح العباد العامة, observing the greater benefit. والقاعدة الشرعية, and the principle in the Sharia states that is consistent, المجمع عليها, that is unanimously agreed upon by all the ulama, is لا يجوز, it is not permissible. إزالة الشر, to repel and to remove a harm, بما هو أشر منه, with a greater evil. You're not allowed to remove a current evil with a what? A greater evil. بَلْ يَجِبُ, or rather what is obligatory is دَرْءُ الشَّرِّ, repelling the evil. بِمَا يُزِيلُهُ, so repel this evil, get rid of this evil with what? Something that's going to get rid of the harm that's already there. أَوْ يُخَفِّفُ, or it will reduces it. Are we all together? So when we are trying to remove an evil, what do we need? Two things. Brothers and sisters, pay attention. If there's an evil, he's a kafir, he's a leader. Is this a harm? Yes, it's a harm. Do we want to remove this harm? Yes, we want to remove this harm. How do we want to remove it? With a means that will either fully get rid of this harm that's currently there, or it's going to reduce it. Even if we're going to come with a harm equal to the current harm that we have, it's not permissible. Let alone a greater harm. Are we all together? أَمَّا دَرْءُ الشَّرِّ بِشَرٍ أَكْثَرَ, as for repelling a evil with a greater evil, فَلَا يَجُوزُ بِإِجْمَعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, by consensus of the Muslims, it's not permissible. Ibn Baz says, فَإِذَا كَانَتْ هَذِهِ الطَّائِفَ, if then this group, الَّتِي تُرِيدُ إِزَالَةَ هَذَا السُّلْطَانِ, then if this group who wants to remove this leader because he's a kafir, الَّذِي فَعَلَ كُفْرًا بَوَحًا, they want to remove this leader who has come with clear-cut kufr, عِنْدَهُمْ قُدْرًا, but they have the strength to زِيلُهُ, by to remove him, بِهَا وَتَضَعُ إِمَامًا صَالِحًا, and they are able to place a righteous leader in the place. إِمَامًا صَالِحًا طَيِّبًا مِنْ دُونِي, without أَنْ يَتَرَتَّبْ عَلَى هَذَا فَسَادٌ كَبِيرٌ, without any greater harm coming from this on the Muslims, عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَشَرٌ أَعْدَمْ, and a greater evil is not going to come to the believers from this. مِنْ شَرِّ هَذَا السُّلْطَانِ, than the evil of this leader. فَلَا بَأْسَ, then there's no harm in doing so, in removing him. أَمَّا إِذَا كَانَ الْخُرُوجُ يَتَرَتَّبُ عَلَيْهِ فَسَادٌ كَبِيرٌ وَاخْتِلَالُ الْأَمْنِ, but if going against this leader is going to produce and it's going to bring about greater evil, or it's going to dismiss and it's going to get rid of safety of the land, وَظُلْمُ النَّاسِ, and the oppression of the people is going to happen, people are going to start oppressing each other, the criminals, the pedophiles and the wrongdoers are going to come out, وَاخْتِيَالِ مَنْ لَا يَسْتَحِقُ الْاخْتِيَالِ, and then people are going to be be assassinated, because the people are going to start taking their guns. إِلَى غَيْرِ هَذَا, and other than that, of the corruptions that are happening, مِنَ الْفَسَادِ الْعَظِيمِ, فَهَذَا لَا يَجُوزُ, then it's not permissible to go against them. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen said, رَحِمَ اللَّهُ, going against the kafir leader, he's kafir, he said, and it's the final quote that we're going to bring, he said, إِن كُنَّا قَادِرِينَ, Ibn Uthaymeen says, if we are able, عَلَىٰ إِزَالَتِهِ to remove him, فَحِينَئِذٍ نَخْرُجُ If we're able to remove him, then we will go against him, the kafir leader. وَإِذَا كُنَّا غَيْرَ قَادِرِينَ But if we're not able to go against the kafir leader, فَلَنَخْرُجُ then we won't go against him. لِأَنَّ جَمِيعَ الْوَاجِبَاتِ Because all of the acts in the sharia which are made obligatory on us, مَشْرُوطَةٌ بِالْقُدْرَةِ وَالْإِسْتِطَاعَ It is stipulated with what? Condition is conditioned that you have to have the ability to do so. Salah, you're told to pray standing up. If you're unable to stand up and pray, what are you told to do? Sit down. Any act in the religion, you are told to do it in accordance to your what? Ability. So going against the leader is one of those obligatory acts. It's all in accordance to our ability. ثُمَّ إِذَا خَرَجْنَا If we go, فَقَدْ يَتَرَتَّبْ عَلَىٰ خُرُوجِنَا مَفْسَدَهُ If we go against him, there might come from it a problem and a harm. أكبر greater وأعظم and bigger مما لو بقي than if he was to remain this man على ما هو in the way he is لأننا خرجنا ثم ظهرت العزة له because when we go against him on strength and power might come for him صرنا أذلة أكثر and then we become more weaker وتمادى في طغيان وكفر أكثر and then he becomes more tyrannical he becomes more of a tyrannical leader hard-headed stubborn doesn't want to listen and he's steps more and goes more into his transgression and his wrongdoing and his kufr. فَهَذِهِ الْمَسَائِلِ Allahu Akbar, I want this last part to be understood properly. These matters, تَحْتَاجُ it requires إِلَىٰ تَعَقُلٍ people to use their brains. وَأَنْ يُقْتَرَنَ الشَّرْعُ بِالْعَقْلِ and that the sharia is also connected and it's brought with the aql. وَأَنْ تَبْعُدَ الْعَاطِفَةِ and we get far from emotions. Let's get away from these videos that people watch on YouTube and then they become so emotional that the person distances himself from emotions في هذه الأمور regarding these issues. فَنَحْنُ مُحْتَاجُونَ لِلْعَاطِفَةِ He says, we do need emotions to feel the pain of our Muslims. وَمُحْتَاجُونَ لِلْعَقْلِ But we are also in need of our intellects. And we are also in need of the sharia. Hatta until la nansaqa wara al-atifa. So our emotions do not what? It doesn't take us so much that we lose our minds and we stop implementing the sharia. Allati tuaddi ila al-halak. And then that emotions that we're living on will lead us to what? It will lead us to destruction. And that's exactly what you see. Oh, brothers, look what's happening. And they put videos on for the people, and another video, and then another video. And then the person, he's left what? He's left leave looking at the Quran and the Sunnah. That's a muqaddimah, inshaAllah ta'ala. Muqaddimah and also usul that we need to agree upon. And then, inshaAllah ta'ala, we will be idhnillahi al-kareem tomorrow. We will go through shubha after the other, one after the other. Any mistake or shortcoming that occurred from me while I was speaking is from me and Shaytan and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.